More storms.
Yeah, not good news for our friends out there. For us, this nor'easter is not going to cause any effect. As a matter of fact, it's going to do a loop-de-loop around us. It's rare for a storm to follow this path, but take a look at what this thing is going to do. First off, the big coastal storm, the nor'easter, that's going to hit the New York, New Jersey area on Wednesday, is now churning through southeastern Missouri. How about that? It's going to take the long route, if you will, all the way down into the Gulf, pick up some steam there, and then then cross Florida and head right on into the Atlantic, roll right up along the coast over the next 2 days, and then make its way into the East Coast area, so portions of the Atlantic state. So they should certainly be on the lookout for the flooding. And unfortunately, this thing is going to come right during high tide. It's about a 4 to 6 foot surge from this tide, and it's right in the middle of the day, and unfortunately they're looking at some big winds, so we think flooding is going to be an issue out there once again. Eventually, as it moves up towards Canada, it's going to bring in some heavier rain and snow, but for us it completely misses us. So let's take a look back home. Right now we have those clouds which are very reluctant to break up. They will later today. These clouds are expected to degrade. It's going to allow our temperature to warm up a little bit. Temperatures are only in the upper 30s at this hour. Typical high temp this time of the year, 56, and we haven't been anywhere near that in quite some time. How about your sunrise today after we've changed those clocks? 6:56, and your sun set today. I think this is going to be the big shocker for a lot of folks. 5:12. So that means by the time many of us get home from work, it's already going to be dark. Get used to it. Won't change until springtime. 38 degrees, your current temperature. Rainfall, we haven't seen any. Humidity is currently at 62%. And your breeze right now coming out of the north at about 8 miles per hour. We find 37 in Butler, 37 also for Greensburg and Morgantown, currently reading at 40. Doppler radar does indicate that we're dry. Expect to be dry today. Next chance for precip will come in the form of rain, which is going to arrive possibly on Wednesday. Not a good chance for that. Satellite radar composite, back edge of the clouds just beginning to make its way towards Akron, Ohio, also degrading a little bit from the south also. So I do think we'll get some sunshine just before our sun set this early evening. As the high continues to move through our region, eventually warmer air starts to come in from the southwest. We do stay dry today, tonight, and tomorrow. And then into Wednesday, weak front drops on in. That'll bring the potential for some showers. I think a few sprinkles will be possible, but that is about it. So here's your hometown forecast. Decreasing clouds for us today. Your high temperature climbs up to 42 in Somerset, 43 for Indiana. Looking up north, only 41 for Oil City. Katanning, we make 44. And in Beaver, we'll be at 45 degrees. Expect for those clouds to break up and give you a little bit of sunshine in Morgantown. Should be nice. 46 degrees, though. Very chilly high temperature. And into Allegheny County, we climb up to 44 degrees in Pittsburgh. And Penn Hills will be at 45. Tonight's low temperature, 27 degrees. Clear skies and relatively soft breeze will allow us to cool down significantly. 49 for you on Tuesday. Great day to get on out to the polls. No rain coming our way. Temperatures warming up a little bit. And yeah, finally some sunshine. Sally.
All right. Thanks very much, Demetrius.